Official response is concentrating on what the government is doing and its action plan to try and address some of the problems. But unofficially, a government source told me that the tone and language of much of the report was hysterical, and there was some serious concerns about the way in which the data had been compiled and analysed and the collection of the information. It's felt that it's not particularly robust or reliable. And essentially, I don't think that this source certainly is taking the report terribly seriously in terms of its findings, although the issue of child sexual exploitation in England is something that the government takes extremely seriously.
Danny, what does the report go into detail about the perpetrators of abuse? Because certainly a couple of newspapers making the point that ethnicity plays a role and yet doesn't feature too highly in this.
Well, the data on the perpetrators of abuse is less robust than the examples of the victims, where there is more information about who the victims are. So I think you have to bear that in mind. It has identified over a 12-month period about 1,500 perpetrators of sexual exploitation, and it breaks their ethnic origin down where it can, but there are a large number of perpetrators whose ethnic background isn't identified. Where it is, you can say that the biggest group are white men, over a third were white, Asian men were identified, about under a third were Asian, which is, of course, disproportionate given the number of Asian people in the population as a whole. But I think what the report is trying to say is that this problem has been characterised by some people in the media as an Asian problem or a Pakistani problem. Pakistani men going out targeting white girls or young white women. That, the report says, is one model. That is one problem, but to just focus on that group would be to ignore the many other examples of abuse across England in which the perpetrators are white or black or other ethnic groups. And I think that is what the report is trying to get at. It's trying to get away from that stereotype and look at it more broadly.